Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel, and today we'll be looking at 5 mobile photography editing apps. Every day we see people sharing their photos in social media, and when they do, they want to look good. That is why the photo editing apps for mobile phones became very popular. There are many choices of apps that have photo editing tools such as filters, brightness, saturation and cropping, but it can be a challenging deciding which ones are the best. In my opinion, here are the 5 best apps you should consider downloading. At the end of the video, I'll tell you which app I used to edit for my photos that I posted in the previous video. And by the time, if you are not subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do subscribe and also don't forget to click the bell icon. Without taking much time, let's get into our topic. At number 5, we have PixelR. This Android and iOS app is a free photo editor app that has over 2 million combinations of effects, overlays and filters. Using PixelR, you can create photo collages with various layouts, background and spacing options. There is also an auto-fix features that balances out the color. One good thing about PixelR is that multiple photos can be layered and blended together. At number 4, we have Adobe Photoshop Express. Adobe Photoshop Express is a free image editing and collage making mobile applications from Adobe. Photoshop Express Editor has various features which can be used to enhance photos. One can perform a range of basic image editing functions, adjust aspects such as contrast and exposure, correct perspectives, remove blemishness and add text. Users can also choose from a range of dynamic effects such as nature, black and white, colored and portrait, etc. There is also one good option called spot healing to remove spots and imperfections. At number 3, we have the famous PixArt. PixArt is one of my most favorite mobile photo apps because it has a ton of features. It can be used for editing photos, making collages and drawing. It also has a built-in social network for sharing your pics. Some of the tools include cropping, perspectives, stretch, artistic filters, borders, masks, text, lens flare and speech bubbles. One best feature that I like about the PixArt is that you can create your own stickers. At number 2, we have something again from Adobe called Lightroom. If one wants to make the picture more polished, then Adobe Lightroom is the best choice. Lightroom presets simplify the photo editing. It also provides some basics like brightness, contrast, exposure and other color corrections in a more professional way. One good thing about the Lightroom is that you won't lose your picture quality after exporting. And last but not the least, the first place goes to my favorite app, Snapseed. This app is available in both Android as well as for iOS platforms. This app provides tremendous editing opportunities that no other apps can provide in mobile platforms. They have presets which you can use for quick filters. You can also customize your own presets. They provide basics like brightness contrast corrections and also provide curves for proper color corrections. It provides many options like lens blur, dual exposure and eye correction. One good thing about Snapseed is that it provides layer editing. Therefore, you can go back and make some changes in the layer in which you are not satisfied. The best part in the Snapseed is the HDRscape. HDRscape enhances the detail and boosts the picture, and hence the picture looks more vibrant than before. Another good thing about Snapseed is that it exports picture to the original quality. My favorite feature in the Snapseed is smart healing. As its name suggests, smart healing reads the algorithm of the picture and enables us to erase the unnecessary things that you want to erase from a picture without causing any disturbance. Smart healing comes into handy when one needs to take an elevated picture of something and wants to erase the rope used. I mostly used Snapseed and Lightroom for most of my pics in the previous video. And that's it guys, if you do end up liking this video, please like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And if you do need a detailed tutorial of how to edit using any of the 5 discussed apps, please do mention in the comment section.
Thank you. Cheers.